Good morning, everyone. I am Rashmi Kaushik from the Department of English and Humanities from JECRC College, Jaipur. Before moving to any particular topic, first I would like to introduce you with the syllabus of our language lab, which includes politics, extempore, group discussion, dialogue writing, and listening comprehension. After these syllabus, there are two topics which comes under subject for a course view, that is antonyms, synonyms and affixes. As you have learned that I taught you about the course view on antonyms, synonyms and affixes, so today's class is basically focused on group discussion. But before telling something about group discussion, I would like to introduce you with the course authors. They are basically three in numbers. As you can see, that when you study phonetics, you are able to have better speaking skills. When you cover your group discussion and listening comprehension, it grooms yourself in various activities like group discussion, listening comprehension skills, etc. And when you cover the extempore part, you are able to write any dialogue regarding any your life situations or any other situations which develop your confidence to speak in your public. So now I'd like to move on group discussion. What is group discussion? Basically, the definition includes that it's an interactive oral process, which means that there are basically 7 to 8 members in a group and they are given a particular topic and 30 to 45 minutes are allotted to them to express their opinions. So in this interactive and oral process, the candidates use to express their views verbally. The second is, it's a group process. As I said, that in a group discussion, there are basically two teams, each team consisting of 7 to 8 candidates, and thus they express their perceptions. The third one is systematic. In this topic, I would like to elaborate that, as I said, there are 7 to 8 candidates in each group. So they used to sit face to face and then they used to express their perceptions or their thoughts. And it, in the same way, it goes systematic. The last one is purposeful and goal-oriented. Every group discussion has some topic, has some objectives. So the candidates which used to give their expressions, they have to keep in mind that it should be goal-oriented. Means the topic which they have been given, it should be in a proper way and it should, the expression should be completing its objective. Now I would like to talk about the characteristics of successful group discussion. Means what should be the things which makes a group discussion successful. The very first is cooperative and friendly atmosphere, which means that the candidates who are participating in the group discussion, they should be cooperating each other and there should be a friendly atmosphere. That means you shouldn't be dominating your other candidates or your fellow candidates. The second is goal-oriented interaction. Means if you are speaking or you are presenting your expression, it should be goal-oriented. The objective should be relevant to the topic. The second is shared leadership, which means that in a group discussion, no one is a particular leader. Every candidate has some responsibility and should perform their responsibility. The last one is effective communication technique. Means if you are participating in a group discussion, you should always keep in mind that the communication technique should be simple, which includes the words which you use should be simple so that others may understand. The sentences should be simple so that others could understand, and the correct articulation of the words. So these are basically the characteristics of successful group discussion. Now the question arises that being a BTech student, why GD is important? You might be thinking that if you are a BTech student, why we should go for group discussion? The answer is very simple. That when there is recruitment process and the companies approach you for the recruitment, they used to see that whether you have the leadership quality, whether you have the capability of problem solving, whether you have the capability of decision making. So these are the basic things which a company looks out for you. Now these are some of the do's and don'ts that in a group discussion what you should do and what you shouldn't. The first is take care of body language. Means if in a group discussion you are expressing your views, you should have a proper body language. The second is talk politely with due respect. Means if another candidate is expressing his views and you are not agreeing to it, you should have some respect and you could have used or said in a proper way, not being very aggressive. The third is be objective in your approach. If you are putting your point, you should be very objective in your approach. Means your expression should be very objective to the given topic. Second is organize your thoughts. Means if you have 3-4 sentences in your mind to express, first you organize them in a proper way so that the first sentence should be at first, the second should be at second, and the last should be at last. The third is be assertive but not dominating. Means if you are very conform to your statement that yes, it's right, then you should have a proper way, or you should have some proper manner in which you express it. You shouldn't be very dominating that no, you are only right and then the others are wrong. And the last one is show agreement when you agree. Means if other candidate is saying something and if you are agreeing to it, just say that yes, you agree to him or her. So these are some of the rules of group discussion. And the last point is what are the don'ts of group discussion, which means what are the things which is not allowed in group discussion. The first is don't lose your temper. Means if you are not agreeing to someone, just don't lose it. Or if someone is making you wrong or pointing you wrong that your statement is not right, just don't lose your temper and just be cool and polite. The second is don't speak too loudly. Because speaking too loudly may sometimes go wrong to the other candidates. The third is don't use aggressive gestures. Means as I said in the first point, that if someone is not agreeing to your point or if you are not agreeing to someone's point, just don't use aggressive gesture. Use some polite language and polite body language. The second last is don't interrupt. In a group discussion, when a person is speaking, let him finish his point first. Just don't interrupt in between. And once he finishes his presentation or his point, then you can talk anything about it after, later on. The last one is don't start speaking without understanding the topic. Means if you don't have the complete understanding of the topic, unless and until, then you please don't speak before getting all it. So I hope that this topic group discussion is almost clear to you. So now, thank you for all.